Good day, everyone, and welcome back to Adventures with Parker, coming at you from the beautiful state of Pennsylvania, here at Hershey Park. Yes, we are back. This is like the reason I went on this trip in the first place, and I am just so excited to get on all the coasters I didn't get to do last time I was here for Christmas Candy Lane, and to revisit my old favorites too, like Candemonium here in the background. Yeah, I am just itching to explore this park, so without any further ado, let the Hershey Adventures begin.
Hi friends, Miss Keith, it's so excited to see you today.
Good morning.
Oh, go ahead. Take
hello.
Oh,
looks
sweet.
Hi. Hello. Okay, so if I learned anything from my last visit, I think that the way to go is to head to the back of the park first. Maybe get a ride on Laugh Track, which I mean I did last time, but I mean if I want to do it again, I should do it now or forever hold my peace, and then from there work my way forward. Of course, we have to say hello to the founder, Mr. Hershey himself. Thanks for the chocolate, Milton, and for fitting this park too. Okay, so I decided to kick things off with wild mouse. I mean, most wild mice are pretty much the same thing, but this one was cool because it had a continuously loading station, so the car didn't stop. It just kind of kept going slowly as you got in, which was nice. I'm sure when it gets really busy, that's super helpful. And from one wild mouse to another, our next ride is going to be Laugh Track. So I was going to do Laugh Track next because I know that one gets some terribly long lines later in the day, but it doesn't seem to be open quite yet. But in the meantime, let's do Wildcat while we're here. Okay, I just did my first ride on the Wildcat, and I was pleasantly surprised by it. I've heard so many stories that this coaster was super rough and super painful and just an all-around PMF coaster, but I am happy to report that that was not my experience. Mind you, I did get a front row ride, and front row rides are known to be smoother, especially on wooden coasters, so maybe that's the secret. Either way, I had an incredible ride, and I would definitely do it again. Maybe not in the back, though. I'm kind of scared for what the back is like now. So it looks like we're getting all of the witties out of the way, because next up is a Lightning Racer. Okay, let's start with the green train here. Now, because I chickened out with Wildcat, I decided to be brave and do the back row here on a Lightning Racer. By the way, this is the Thunder side, according to the front of the train. But of course, now we got to do it again on the Lightning side, because I am a credit fiend. I was going to say another word, but this is a family show. But yeah, round two, let's go. Okay, so I just did the Lightning side of Lightning Racer, and still a fun ride, but I got stuck on the brake run for a couple of minutes. I don't know exactly how long. I want to say maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes at most, no more than that. Also, Thunder won again, so if you ask me which one I like better, I'm going to have to say Thunder, because I like to be a winner. In all seriousness, I really do love the dueling nature of the ride. This is the first dueling coaster I've actually done where it actually duels. Because I've been on Dragon Challenge, but they weren't dueling. They quit that a long time ago. And I've also been on Racer 75 at King's Dominion, but they were only running the one side when I was there. So it was cool to finally get that dueling coaster experience, and it was so much fun. Okay, so the cool thing about Hershey's water park, which is known as the boardwalk, by the way, is that it's pretty much just part of the park. Like, there's no separate entrance to it. You're in the park and then you're in the water park. Now, I do not have my bathing suit with me in my backpack right now, but I do have it in my car, in my suitcase. So maybe after I get my credits out of the way, I'll come back and take a dip, because there seems to be some really cool water slides here. Okay, I am so hungry right now. I actually haven't had a proper meal since yesterday at Knoebels. Mind you, that was a very, very late lunch, but yeah, I am starving. So I'm gonna go here to Chickies and Pete's, home of the world famous crab fries. So I actually didn't get crab fries, but I did decide to get the Pete's famous Philly cheesesteak, because I'm in Pennsylvania. I have to get some cheesesteak. I also got myself the souvenir drink cup, which gives me free refills every hour, which I think is a great deal because I get so dehydrated at these parks, and yeah, this will keep me on track with my fluids. This is so messy, but so good. Okay, looks like Laugh Track is open, but it's not the short line I was hoping for. Still not bad, so I'm going to tough it out. Alright, I finally got that ride on Laugh Track. It's fun, I still like it. I definitely prefer the Christmas version though. I just added something extra special. I also didn't spin as much, but that's always just luck of the draw when it comes to spinning coasters. So I pretty much accomplished everything that I wanted to do on this side of the park, and everything has been a walk-on so far with the exception of Laugh Track. So now it's time for me to work my way back to the front and do some of the ones I missed. And these next few coasters are the ones I've been most looking forward to. That's Fahrenheit, SkyRush, Storm Runner, Great Bear. I am so excited for these ones. So let's go do them. Okay, just got up of Fahrenheit, which was an awesome ride. I love intamin rides just in general, and Fahrenheit was no exception. And I was excited for this one. I kind of had the feeling that it was an underrated coaster because not a lot of people talk about it, but it looked good. And that is the case. It is so good. So much fun. My favorite moments has to be the corkscrews, which are super whippy, and one of the last puffs of airtime before doing that final helix. Yeah, overall, Fahrenheit is looking hot. And here we can see Hersheypark's new for 22 editions, Mixed, which is the crazy Zamperla Nebula you see in front of me. That just looks so wild and so mesmerizing. As well as Jolly Rancher Remix, which is a, remix of the old Boomerang ride, Sidewinder. Thank you. So this is kind of neat. When the lower arm is loading and unloading, the people up top are, you know, still chilling up there, kind of like a Ferris wheel. All right, so I just did mixed, which is this super fun flat ride behind me, and yeah, well, I just said it. It's really fun. I like that it's tame enough that kids could enjoy it, but also fast enough and thrilling enough that it appeals to people of any thrill preference. It's kind of cool because as you're swinging up and over, it looks like you're going to collide with the arm in front of you, but obviously the ride is designed so that doesn't happen, but just the thought of it is freaky, but cool at the same time. Now, I will say I'm not a fan of how long you have to wait up there while the bottom gets unloaded and loaded again. You are up there for quite a while and it's super boring, and there's nothing really that can be done about it. It's just part of the ride's design, but yeah, just be prepared to sit up there for a while. But on the bright side, you get to see the ride cycle twice, so I guess that's kind of a blessing. Gotta love this graveyard of cell phones.
Dang.
Don't take your phone on the rides, people. All right, we're about to board Storm Runner. So excited. This is the most anticipated coaster of this trip. Of course, just before I'm about to get on Storm Runner, we have to stop and wait because of an actual storm. So I was going to wait it out, but because it's not even raining all that much, but I think the concern is lightning. I think the warning is going to pass for another couple of hours. But yeah, maybe this is my chance to grab some ice cream, maybe get some crab fries, because I'm still itching to try some of those. And we'll see what else is open. I saw the train go by just a bit ago, so maybe we'll try our luck there. On the bright side, the rain is making things cool down a bit, which is really nice because it's been so hot the past couple of days. My Canadian skin cannot handle it. I've just been in a constant state of sweatiness this whole trip, so finally I get a bit of relief. When roller coasters get you down, you can always take the train. So unfortunately with the weather, I think my water park plans are out the window. It does look like a nice little water park. I might need to come back and try it on another day. Okay, this cow outside of Chick-fil-A is so adorable. Eat more chicken, it says. Although I would rather get my chicken somewhere other than Chick-fil-A for reasons. Something that I really love about Hershey Park is that there's no dedicated kids section, but there's kiddie rides strewn throughout the park. So, you know, if the older kids are going to ride the big coasters, there's always something for the little ones to do nearby. And although I like having themed environments for kids, this setup is pretty neat too. All the coasters I want to ride are still closed, but there is one coaster that I saw running. Do I dare be a cringe enthusiast and get the credit? It's raining, guys. What else can I do? We're doing it. Don't blame me, blame the weather. Yep, I got the Coco Cruiser credit. And the rain too, so you know what? There's something to be said about that. I don't know what that is exactly, but there's something to be said. Hands up to the sky. Rain on me, tsunami. I'm up to fly. Rain on me. Oh man, I am soaked. But I can't even see. I'm gonna try to get a ride on the monorail because it just opened. And it is probably the perfect rain ride. But I'm gonna be soaked by the time I get there. Holy moly. Never mind, it's closed. I thought this would be the one ride that could run, but I guess it's an open air cabin. It's not like Disney's monorails that are fully enclosed. So it makes sense. Kind of sucks though, because like, what do I do now? Actually, I know exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go get a milkshake. Let's do it. I'm so excited. I've been craving Hershey milkshake since I was here in November, so let's get one. I mean, that thing down there is running, so I don't think I'd fit on it, but maybe it's an option. Question mark?
Simply chocolate. This is the place to get the milkshakes. It looks like they have quite a few interesting flavors too, so... decisions.
Okay, so even if I don't ride any more roller coasters today, I did acquire a Kissing Tower milkshake. And I mean, that makes the drive and the whole entire visit worth it, right? It looks so good. It was pretty expensive though. It's about $16 USD, so bear that in mind. But I mean, it's basically an entire meal, so that's how I'm justifying it. That's really good. Yeah, my milkshake craving has been satisfied. So when I bit into this top part, I expected it to be just like a milk, chocolate, whatever, but it's cake! It's cake! And it's good cake too. I'm in chocolate heaven right now. Something I love about Hershey Park is that they have a few classic dark rides, very similar to Knoebels actually, but it just fills me with so much nostalgia to see them and to be able to ride them, because a lot of these rides you only see at carnivals and fairs and stuff, not necessarily at, you know, permanent theme park establishments like this. So yeah, it's just a nice little thing that I absolutely adore. Especially the Tilt-a-Whirl, which was my absolute favorite when I was a kid. Oh, we have coasters starting to go. That's so exciting. Oh man, that gives me hope. Here comes the sun, doo 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 doo. Here comes the sun, and I say, let's ride some coasters. All right, so it looks like the park is starting to return to normal operations again, which is super exciting. It means I get to go on more rides. I think for the rest of the day, I'm just going to focus on the credits that I need, especially Great Bear, Storm Runner, and SkyRush. If I get on those three coasters, then I will consider this day a success. Mind you, I've been having a ton of fun regardless, but yeah, if I can get those three, then it will have been a perfect day for me. Okay, I've been trying to find the entrance to Great Bear, but I've been having some great difficulties doing that. But we are right by Super Duper Looper, so maybe we'll do that while we're here. Okay, Super Duper Looper was, well, super duper. Okay, all kidding aside, I just thought it was going to go through the loop and that was it. That was the end of the ride. But that is not the case. It actually has some really cool interactions with Great Bear and with Comet and with a few other rides. So that was cool. There's also a tunnel in there. So yeah, I was actually really pleasantly surprised by Super Duper Looper. So glad I got to do that. Oh, and the loop. So a bit of roller coaster history / engineering stuff to throw at you here. Normally loops on a roller coaster are kind of teardrop shaped. It just helps something to do with the forces. Yes. I don't know exactly what, yes. But something to do with the forces.
The forces, they get you, right?
Right, yeah. But on Super Duper Looper, it's a circular loop. You feel it on your body a little differently than other roller coaster loops. So it was just a really unique and really cool experience in that regard. Okay, just did Great Bear, which is a very interesting invert. One of the weirder ones out there, but super fun. I especially loved the 0G roll, and there was also a Heartline roll somewhere in there. That was just really whippy and just so fun. But yeah, it's kind of weird because it's so spread out all over the place. Also, the first drop, it kind of has this little helix before dropping down. So yeah, it's definitely an unconventional layout, but still effective. really fun ride.
Once you're seated, pull down on your shoulders.
Okay, things are popping in the Jolly Rancher station here. So the colors of the lights up here actually correspond to the flavor that you get in the flavor tunnel. So it has scents in there. But as you can see, the lights are pink, which means that they are going to get the watermelon scent. All right, so I just got off of Jolly Rancher Remix, which was the second ever boomerang that I've done. Before this, I've only done the bat at Canada's Wonderland, and this one was really cool. I love the scent tunnel. We got the cherry flavor. And yeah, you can really smell it when you're in there. This boomerang also has different restraints than I'm used to, because our boomerang uses the old arrow restraints because our trains came from Dragonfire. For a boomerang, it was a home run for me. Okay, so we're making good progress. I just got off the Comet. I wasn't expecting much from this coaster, but it had the buzz bars just like Phoenix at Knoebels yesterday. So that gives it that extra room for those good pops of airtime. So that was super fun. And it's a long one too. So you have a nice lengthy ride. Super smooth for a wooden coaster too. And now we have seen SkyRush test, which makes me hopeful that it might be open. Hopefully it is. Stay tuned. Also, I'm here with my new friend Dane, who's also a coaster enthusiast. He's been showing me around. We've been having a great time. Okay, the line doesn't look like it's open quite yet, but it looks like we have someone coming down, which means it's just about time. Oh man, I'm so excited. Wow. All right, we just did SkyRush. What did you think of it, Dane?
It was fun. Back rows, definitely the best row.
Oh yeah, absolutely. So we did in the front first, and then we did in the back, but the back row, oh man, so crazy. I will say it does hurt your thighs a little more in the back, but totally worth it. The airtime is absolutely insane on that ride. Easily my new favorite ride in the park. We're just a few minutes away from park closing, and we are trying to rush over to Storm Runner because we did see it go, and that's the one credit I need. I mean, that and Trailblazer, but Trailblazer isn't open today. So yeah, but I need Storm Runner. Besides SkyRush, that was the one I was most looking forward to on this trip. So hopefully we get there in time.
Oh yeah, there it goes.
Oh yeah, awesome. Okay, we'll see you in a bit. All right, we just got our last ride of the night on Storm Runner. What a way to end the night.
Sure.
Yeah, I know, that was awesome. The flying snake dive was so cool. And you're saying that's the only coaster that has that kind of immersion in the world?
Yeah, one of the only coasters.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know, that was so cool. That was the perfect way to end the night. I mean, if I could have made the day any better, maybe if I could have gotten a ride on Candemonium. But I mean, I did it last time, so I'm not too upset about that. I still got on a ton of awesome coasters today. Of course, we need to get some Starbucks for the drive home, or not to home, we're headed to Pittsburgh now for Kennywood. Yes, that's where you're from. Kennywood's your home park. That is going to do it for my day here at Hershey Park, and I am definitely leaving Hershey Park happy. My day was sweet through and through. Yeah, we got on so many new coasters. We got to experience a lot of other fun things along the way too. And even though we got rained out for a bit, I mean, I still got to do everything I wanted to do. Like I said, maybe if I could have done Candemonium, that would have just been the little cherry on top, but I'm okay without doing it. I still had an excellent day all the way around. And like I said, I got to spend it hanging out with some friends too, which always makes a theme park day better. But yeah, if you would like to see more of my theme park travel, local, and outdoor adventures, be sure to subscribe. I have lots of awesome content coming your way. You can also find me on social media at @adbparker. And once again, thank you for watching. And until next time, the adventures are calling. See ya. Rain on me!